if you will not give budget, yeah. And how can they grow?
Okay, I got that. Not all colleges and state universities are like PUP and UP. Yeah. We got that. So they are in a different class, different from each other, different capacities and different capabilities and different assets. Yes, sir.
Well, the other source of money for bridging that gap, you know, between the NEP and the target level of appropriation will be the PDAF, the PDAF.
Yes.
Or Priority Development Assistance Funds of the legislators themselves. And in fact, that's happening now, you know, certain senators and congressmen are committing part of their PDAF.
Park their funds in the state colleges and universities, and even in hospitals, yes.
Yeah. Mm-mm. So that's one source.
Okay. But do you, one of the things that I read and one of the rationalization of the appeal of the president for the government's position, or for Malacanang's position to be understood, is that iba na yung priorities ngayon eh. Mm. Ang nakikita nilang kailangan tulungan ay yung basic education, which is elementary and high school, because according to them, based on studies, I don't know conducted by whom, nag-uumpisa mag-aral ang mga bata, and then by the time they get out of high school, by the time they get out of elementary, lumiliit sa high school, at lalong lumiliit ang pupunta sa college. Ang gusto nilang gawin, bigyan nila ng maraming suporta ang elementary education para matapos yung batang ito. At least tapusin man lang yung kanyang pre, meron na bang, ano ngayon, prep?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hanggang matapos yung kanyang elementary para mag-stay rin siya sa high school. Because maliit na rin ang mga numero ng mga estudyanteng nakakatapos. And ang sinasabi nila is 14% na lang.
Yeah, pagdating sa college.
So yun ba ay naniniwala kayo dun sa mga ganung explanation na nanggagaling sa Malacañang?
Kasi pagka ganun ang sinundan natin,
opo.
Yung tinatawag nating principle ng education process, tayo na mismo ang sumira. Mm-hmm. Kasi sa principle ng education process, kinakailangan yung elementary, so supportahan mo yan, para i-prepare mo siya sa high school. Mm-hmm. At yung sa high school naman, adjusted na sila, they are trained para maging mapunta sa college. Mm-hmm. So in short, kapag kahalimbawa, hindi mo sila inakay papuntang college, hindi pitan mo masyado papuntang college, talagang hindi mo mapipil in ang gap sa college. In which case, isang reason lang yon para hindi mo nga mapundahan ng college. And it is very important kasi na mapundahan mo yung college. Why? Kasi sa college, when you fund sa education, basically, nagpapans ka dyan, hindi sa ano, hindi ka parang nagpans sa Department of Public Works eh, na ito pera, magpagawa ka ng kalye, magpagawa ka ng bridge. O kaya ito ang pera, sa DND, bumili ka ng bala, bumili ka ng baril. Ito iba eh. Kasi ang pinapansin mo rito, yung brain ng mga bata, ang kanilang values, ang kanilang culture. So in short, ito'y dapat pag-aralan.
Very sensitive. Ang nagiging priority nga nila is ang nakikita nga nila kung ano nga yung shape ng pagtatapos ng isang batang pumapasok sa elementary, sa high school, sa college. Kasi, so ang sinasabi lang nila sa panahong ito, 2011, nakikita natin na ang gusto nilang pondohan ng mas malaki dun sa total budget na 174 billion ba yun? 174 billion, no?
It's much higher now. I think it's even more than that for basic education.
I ilagay sa basic education. Yun lang ang sinasabi nila because yun nga ang nakikita nila. Is that what they're saying?
I think that's a very valid proposition because basically you will strengthen the inputs to college.
Mas dadami ang dadating sa college because inalagaan mo, pinondohan mo ng teacher, ng classroom, ng kung ano man yan. They stay and finish their elementary. They stay and finish their high school.
Right.
So you will benefit definitely yung college nila. So hindi nagbabawas.
Maybe not so much in terms of number, but in terms of quality.
Quality because and number right, siguro ang hinahabol.
Yeah, but that will aggravate the situation in the tertiary level, you know, if you increase the number.
You increase the number, but you also increase the...
It's the quality because now, like in the case of UP, if we admit students... based on their grades in the entrance examination, you know. Then the graduates of private high schools have the advantage. And normally these are students coming from well-to-do families. And that keeps on continuing.
Schools, graduates from private schools.
And we will not be able to get graduates from far-flung places of the country because they're coming from poorly, poor quality basic education, essentially. So there, it makes sense, you know, to really strengthen the basic education,
yes,
to strengthen or enhance the capability of students coming from poor areas.
Mm-mm.
To get into public university, like UP, like PUP. Okay? But should it be done at the expense of the support
college
for the tertiary education?
Okay.
Are there other uses of funds?
Is it a rational way of allocation here?
No.
Is there a rational way of allocating here? What is the cost of a college education in a state college and university?
Kasi basically, no? Dapat yan kasi per student ang ratio, ang ano niya, ang cost is about 50,000 per student
a year per
oh, student. Pero that is not exactly what is happening
sa tertiary ito.
Oh, sa tertiary, oh, at least 50,000.
But pero in the private sector they produce more efficiently the graduates because they operate at a lower per student cost. So I think what government is saying is because SUs is have these powers given to them under Republic Act 82-92, corporate powers, they can enter into all kinds of arrangements, raise income, retain income, use income. They can actually be more productive and more efficient in educating the youth.
Yes.
I mean, if you push this to its ultimate conclusion, in effect, the government is saying, you know, let's not have any more public universities at the tertiary level.
Mm-hmm.
Because if state-owned universities and colleges will be financially self-sufficient, they can operate like private universities.
No, I think subsidy will still be there, but they have to use also the income. That's what exactly the law
it
says.
It could be going there.
Yeah. It looks like it's going there.
It looks like it's going
but
there.
Do we want it to go there?
Yes. Comments from Alex, with your permission, gentlemen. Alex of Santa Mesa, oy, malapit sa PUP ito. Ah. Nung nag-enroll ako ng second sem sa PUP, napansin namin na kailangan ng ayusin. Bulok na ang itsura ng buong campus namin. Paano pa namin ma-utilize ang budget namin? From Joy of UP, Diliman, okay lang kasi malaki naman ang potential ng campus namin para kumita sa iba't ibang activities. Mrs. Ramos of Dinagat Island. Where's Dinagat Island? Hi. Not all state universities and colleges students come from poor families. Why are they being subsidized when we need more money for basic education for the poor? Yun ang nagiging debate ngayon, ano? So, ang unang question is kinat ba o hindi kinat? So, depending on ano yung items na tinitingnan nyo, you're saying na may kinat, ang sinasabi nila hindi. It is the total amount and the inept that we're only talking about. And then now, it is now the rationale of why the budget is allocated in that way in terms of tertiary and basic education. So ang punto ngayon na ang paninindigan nyo ay paano natin bibigyan ng karapat-dapat na allocation from these funds for education? How should you allocate now? Is it based on the number of students that you will project in the next how many years? Six years. Ito 'yon. So, ito yung number, so ito na yung pera. Pero ito yung papasok sa basic education. Talagang malaki ang magiging allocation for basic education because mas marami.